to the Abandoned Secret Beast Episode 1 English dub. That's just brutal. Squad.
Commence the attack.
The ability to transform into creatures from is it a dragon? Wow. Amazing. The Incarnate Squadron, Hellhound, Centaur. That's some kind of iguana and a gargoyle. Or rather, Archangel. A rhinoceros? So let's see a armored skin siren. Spider legs. Whoa. I don't think we saw him much in this season. Snake. Three-headed serpent. Minotaur. Such phenomenal abilities, but they're bound to have negative repercussions.
Fortress was considered impregnable, but you and your men took it with ease.
Your
reputation is well earned, Special Sergeant Major Henriette.
You flatter me, sir. If only we had arrived sooner, many of our countrymen lost their lives.
Oh, don't worry about that. They gave their lives to help secure a northern victory. An honorable sacrifice.
Really?
Anyway, excellent work out there today. Now rest up before your next mission.
Sir.
These
incarnates are lifesavers, but they're unnatural. Should we really put so much trust in such creatures?
She's silver soon.
No weapons, nothing more. We just have to use them properly, that's all.
So you think of them nothing more than weapons? That's something I might have mentioned, right?
We're back.
Come in. You're safe. Thank goodness. Hank, Kane, good to see you.
Well, if the mission had been directed in the field by the Major, we'd have likely died honorably in battle.
Easy now. That kind of talk could get you in trouble.
So what's the prognosis of our soldiers?
Unfortunately, it looks like a few of them had their symptoms progress during this last battle.
I see.
Ouch.
I'll figure something out. The Incarnates were my creation, after all. It's my responsibility.
We know you will. The whole team has faith in you. And of course, I do too.
Are these familiar? Are Brianna? No.
Still here.
Awkward.
Guess I'll go check on the rest of the company!
He hasn't changed since we were kids.
Oh, childhood friends. So that's not gonna last very long.
Nice looking bunch. Didn't you tell me your daughter Shawl is running the orphanage all by herself these
then
days?
Just, yeah.
My wife passed away when Shawl was still just a little girl.
That's Todd.
She does a wonderful job.
It seems like you're really proud of her.
Erica Lindbeck.
Oh,
gonna be an attractive
so
one.
Jealous. I don't want a family with a daughter like that someday. I know. Why don't you introduce me to Shawl?
Don't push her luck. Most of those skins have kind of pigments on them.
When the war's over, you should all stop by for a visit. Shawl and the kids would be thrilled.
Yes!
Well, wait a minute. Captain Henriette!
At ease, everyone. You seem happy. What's up? Some good news.
Take a look at Will's daughter. Beautiful, isn't she? He said he'd introduce me to her and that she's a wonderful girl and very family-oriented. Got a good feeling. She and I are gonna hit it off like two kids in a fairy tale. Certainly something to look forward to.
Captain? I thought you only had eyes for Dr. Elaine. You shouldn't be ogling other boys.
Where's the eyes,
Captain? Shawl and I are destined to be. What about Dr. Elaine?
What is wrong with those guys?
What about her?
Yeah, I'm
sure she has that too. I assume she's waiting on you to make
it. As far as they're not engaged yet. I'm curious.
The war's over.
Pathetic. And I'm way too late for that.
The gang's all here. What's going on?
Nothing. We just need a captain. You won't believe it. The captain and the captain. Like I said, nothing.
Was this about me?
No, not at all.
You can't rush love, but you can't take too long either. Sometime later. Quite the impenetrable defense. The symptoms are expanding. This is gonna be copyrighted in the live action. As long as it is. Probably freaks. I feel for Siren. Peaceful days in the battlefield, but that doesn't last forever. And so one day, then something happens that changes everything. The serpent one. Uh-oh. Trouble. Oh, they're supposed to be captured. They surrendered. Poison gas. Whoa. It's like he's lost control of his incarnate abilities. Hand to the face. Boom. Last words. Before he was killed in combat.
No! Say something, Captain. I didn't. It's not me. Get a medic!
Not gonna help him after he attacked him in friendly fire.
This man's a soldier.
It's okay, Captain.
I'm so sorry.
What's he doing? He took his own life. Damn. That was gonna cause PTSD. I said you're not having any of them. Hint and I were just happened today.
A while back, he said,
sometimes when I'm playing as an incarnate, I have a hard time remembering which version of myself is the real me.
Huh?
Who knows? Maybe one day I will be able to change back.
Bobby,
it's a scary thought.
Just kidding. It was a bad joke.
His eye.
Something.
Strong possibility.
I'm so sorry.
Unless they revert back to human forms. They do end up going berserk. What then?
Alright, listen up. We still don't have any idea what made Avi go berserk. There's a lot we don't know about incarnates and their powers. And yes, it's entirely possible that what happened to him could happen to any of us. But remember, we are not beasts. We are soldiers and we have our own will and pride. We will swear an oath, my fellow incarnates, right here and now. Those who have lost their souls shall be slain by their own.
That's right.
Should something similar ever happen to one of us, a fellow incarnate should be the one to stop it.
Not a human soldier.
We've dedicated our lives to this country. Let's make sure everything we've done wasn't for nothing by facing this together. None of us are ever alone. Never forget that as long as you live.
Talk about a bittersweet ending. So much for her creations. I feel for Elaine. The battlefield goes on. More lives are lost. More incarnates fall. More casualties. More tragic moments in the battlefield.
Thank you all for enduring this
debate. Only a few of them are left.
Tomorrow we set out to capture the capital. This will be our most intense battle yet. But if we succeed... Once this war is finally over,
about time.
I want all of you to be there for the ceremony.
Aww.
That's a direct order.
Too bad those
so
are there.
Stay alive out there.
Don't want to see the wedding. Too bad they never got to see it. But Dustin had other plans.
Here you are. Still alive, huh?
Tomorrow's going to be a rough battle. I want to be prepared for anything. Since the beginning, every mission we've been assigned was considered a lost cause. While we may be powerful as incarnates, surviving this war has never been easy. The only reason we've managed to make it this far is because of your leadership. We couldn't have asked for better, Annie. That's not the reason. Everyone's belief in me made me want to never let them down. The entire squad, plus you and Elaine, make me want to be the best captain I can be.
It's very touching.
Mr. Modesty, do you remember the very first time you met me in Elaine?
Sure do. Who would ever have imagined it? A rich kid like you and two war orphans would end up becoming inseparable friends.
It is odd, huh? Listen, Hank, take care of her. Elaine is trying. trying to deal with everything on her own, and the weight of it all is crushing her. You're the only one she'll listen to.
That's not entirely accurate. Plan on giving up.
Divided into north and south will soon become one again.
You're certain of this?
Yes.
Damn. But not only that.
It's over. We'll finally have the peace we've dreamed of for so long.
I don't know about that.
But you and I will have no place in a peaceful world.
What do you mean by that?
Snap. Betrayal. Incarnate bullets. Change.
Everyone who's become an incarnate will eventually lose themselves completely, both in body and in soul. And that means you too, Hank. I failed you. I'm so sorry. When that time comes, you'll lose all sense of reason. Won't be able to control your powers. I went over my research again and again. No matter what I tried, nothing changed the outcome. If the incarnates are alive and roaming free when that happens, they'll be a greater threat than this war ever was. Before that happens, it is my duty as the creator of the incarnates to ensure that threat never comes to pass. I can't let you all turn into monsters.
What did you say? Yes. You're welcome. No, you won't. And Kane steps in. No.
With these bullets, they should die without suffering. After that, you and I will need to take our own lives. Then everyone involved with the incarnates will be dead and gone.
Sorry, but no.
Change of plans. Double cross got double crossed. Elaine. Tell me you can. No. Sometime later. Award.
I can't believe you actually woke up. You incarnates sure are a resilient bunch.
Sure, really.
Military hospital. I'm Second Lieutenant Liza Renee Castle, part of Patria Union's military intelligence. Nice to meet you, Special Sergeant Major Hank Henriette. You've been here and in a coma for 2 months now.
2 months?
About the same amount of time the war's been over.
Oh, snap. Memories come flooding back.
Where are the rest of my squad? Where are they?
That's actually the reason I was assigned to be here.
No sound
of them. The same day you were found on the verge of death, Dr. Elaine Blue Lake disappeared without a trace and has been missing ever since. The incarnates were officially disbanded. And I was sent off by Kane Madhouse to live as civilians wherever they wished.
Disbanded my fort.
The former squad started to lose their scent. Several instances ended in destruction and multiple deaths.
That filthy rat.
The incarnates, once saviors of Patria and regarded as gods, are now feared and hated by the people. So what's going on? You must have some sort of insight on this?
A trigger.
We lost all contact with him right after the final battle.
Damn him. Hank is furious. Oh, it's on. The bastard's got hell to pay. The fate that awaits. Those that lose their souls, they'll be slain by their own. One by one, he tracks them down.
Killing off your former comrades.
Damn you.
Those who have lost their souls shall be slain by their own.
He forgot that oath.
I'm here to keep the oath we made.
We became heroes because of this power. No gods. If Asian defies the will of a god, they deserve punishment.
Not your right to be judged your execution. Destroy them. Exploding harpoon. And so the hunt begins. To the Abandoned Sacred Beast, Episode 1. Epilogue. And enter Elaine with another fury of her own. Episode 2.
When the time comes for you to pull the trigger, I know
the Dragon's Daughter.